Spring like, I tell you what, mid-80s pretty much the rest of the week. We just got to get rid of this fog across our northern locales. We'll talk more about that in a second. The other big story, of course, is the rainfall. You go back to January, folks, and we had a record dry month. Every reporting city broke the record for the least amount of rain for the month. So just kind of a testament of how dry it was in the month of January. Now, however, February has been a little more helpful to us in that department. In fact, just Sunday night on into Monday here, we had nearly an inch of rain, if not more, in many locales. And that's helping our drought situation now here across Central Florida. Yes, we're still running a departure for the month of February, but look at how much rain we've received. And that's a lot more than the month of January. So we're going in the right direction. We even have a surplus now here in Orlando month to date for February. Melbourne's still running a deficit, but we're starting to see the rain return. And in fact, you take a look at what's going on here, things are quiet for now. So it looks like a dry couple of days, but there is more rain in the forecast as we get you towards the end of the work week into the weekend. We'll talk about that here in a second. The other story today, look at these low clouds locked into Ocala, keeping those temperatures in the mid-60s there. While in town, Orlando, over towards Kissimmee, Winter Haven, sun busted on out earlier today. Temperature highs up around the 80-degree mark, officially 80 at the airport, by the way, and lower 80s as you went on into Polk County. Winds are kind of light now out of the north and the northeast, so fog, again, will be a concern overnight tonight. And look at the reduced visibilities up towards Ocala because of the low clouds, 3 miles visibility there. On into Orlando and Point South, we're in much better shape. So after midnight again, 1, 2, 3 o'clock in the morning. Fog will be locally dense as it was early this morning, but the temperatures not bad at all. In fact, come daybreak tomorrow morning, coming in at about 61 degrees, fog will form shortly after the midnight hour, be locally thick in a few locales come daybreak tomorrow morning. But the temperature scheme here, well above average, and it's staying that way. That big dome of high pressure well off to our east. Long fetch of flow over the peninsula, south-southeast, will mean a warm afternoon. Computer models picking up on a little bit of moisture tomorrow. I think what we're going to see is just a little bit of a cue deck develop, otherwise relatively dry. Golfers loving the forecast. 80 at noon, 85 by the afternoon. Don't forget the sunblock this time of the year. Very easy to get a sunburn. Afternoon highs tomorrow all across the board running 80 to about 85 degrees. Having said that, then let's take a peek now at your extended 7-day forecast. Check in with Amy and Kimberly tomorrow morning to get the update on the fog and the visibilities in your locale. 80 at lunchtime, 83 at 5. In between, right at about 85 degrees. Sunny, warm, and breezy on Thursday, 86. Jim and Martha on Friday, even warmer, 87. Front arriving on Saturday night on into Sunday. Big change in the temperatures from Saturday to Sunday.